So I'm a data scientist based in the UK, and I've also got a master's in data science. In this video, I'm going to explain to you why I think a master's in data science could be beneficial for you, and also whether or not you really need one to become a successful data scientist. Hey everyone, welcome to the channel. My name is Leon. I'm a data scientist based in the UK, and I've also got a master's in data science. And so previously I was working as an analyst, and then I had to make the decision to quit the job and pursue the data science master's. And so I had the same questions as you might do right now, which are probably things like, is it worth the time and money? Is it worth giving up my job for? Do I even need a master's in data science to become a data scientist? And so now that I'm actually working as a data scientist, I think it's worth it for me to go through what I think about the whole experience and also what my thought process was at that time, because doing a master's is a big decision to make. And so hopefully by telling you my experience, it helps you in answering those questions that you might have. I'm going to go over three key points that I think are important to think about. And hope you find it useful. So the first thing that I think is important to consider is, what's your current background? Do you have a computer science background? Do you have a maths background like me? Or do you have a business background? The reason I say this is because data science is a complex, multidisciplinary field. And so there's quite a high educational barrier to entry. You need good technical skills like programming and also math skills, basic statistics, linear algebra in some cases. You also need basic soft skills like communication, teamwork skills. You need to be able to present well. You have to have a good, solid business understanding. And so it's only when you use these all together and you apply them to solve business problems that you have a data scientist. Now, the good thing is most data science masters are quite flexible. And so you can pick and choose the things that you're interested in. And if you know certain areas that you're not good at, you can focus on those areas instead. And by doing so, you'll have a plan and you can really kind of forget everything else and just focus on improving the areas that you want to improve and learning the things that you really enjoy learning. So for me personally, I was really interested in topics like machine learning and also other computer science topics like cloud computing, big data systems, etc. I didn't really focus much time on maths, and that's because my background was maths. And so, you know, things like statistics, linear algebra, I feel like I didn't really need to learn those again. And so most of my data science was based on the computer science modules. It let me kind of even out my skill set. And I think that's the benefit of a master's, is that if you can pick wisely, you can really start to improve on the things that you're not very good at. And employers like that, you know, as a graduate, they just want you to have kind of a well-rounded skill set. And by having the master's degree, it lets them know that you are qualified, at least to the minimum level. So I think some people watching this are probably looking to transition over into data science from another career. And you're trying to decide whether or not it's worth actually giving up your current career entirely and then going back to being a full-time student again. Now, I don't know about you, but I absolutely hated the idea of going back to school and taking exams again. And so for me to give up my income entirely, especially after I've just graduated and I'm finally earning some money, and I also saved up a bunch of money as well, and having to dip into that in order to pay for my master's was not an easy decision to make. And so you might be wondering, you know, why did I decide to go for it anyway? And actually the main reason for that is because I used to work as an analyst, and for me to go from an analyst to a data scientist, it might have took me like at least 3 to 4 years. And now depending on your current career, that might take longer. For me, the trade-off was I'd have to pay the £10,000, I wouldn't be earning anymore, but I would be compressing my learning and I would be progressing much faster. I also knew that data scientist positions have generally quite high educational requirements, and so by doing the master's, I can hit those minimum requirements whilst also developing the skills that I felt like I was lacking. So if you were like me, you didn't have that much work experience, but you want to compress your learning so that you can progress much faster, and you also have the financial means to do so, then I definitely think the master's in data science is worth considering. So to be honest, I found this whole data science thing when I was looking to move on to better jobs from my analyst job. And so at that time, I was mainly focused on the financial benefits of working as a data scientist, but not so much the day-to-day role of a data scientist. And I think that's mainly thanks to the recent hype of data science. A lot of people are looking to transition over into data science with the dream of becoming a data scientist, but not necessarily having the interest at looking at what's actually involved. Now, I don't think there's necessarily anything wrong with that, but I do think it's important in this case to take a step back and reassess yourself and have a look at if you would really truly enjoy doing the mundane things that we have to do every day. So things like cleaning bad data, dealing with bad code, managing stakeholders, dealing with bad reports. These are things that are done almost every day, but I think they're generally quite neglected by people that are studying data science. This obviously depends on your company, and it also depends on, you know, what kind of team that you have. But I think for most data science roles, you're just going to be doing the boring stuff like managing and cleaning bad data. And you're just probably going to spend most of your time trying to communicate simple things. You know, a lot of times people are not very knowledgeable in that area, and part of your job is to just be able to communicate properly. And so there's a lot of these things that are not really explored, in my opinion, where especially when you're a student of data science, you don't really explore these areas enough. And so it's quite important to think about what's realistically expected if you do actually get paid as a data scientist. So I actually think the best way of knowing whether you'll enjoy working as a data scientist is just by doing projects. There are a lot of projects online where the data is already nicely cleaned. You know, a lot of people have already tried it, but I would recommend doing something where the data is bad and also not a lot of people attempted it, but also pick something where the concept is very hard to explain to most people. And the reason I say that is because I think one of the biggest challenges of data science is just being able to communicate your results properly and clearly. Once you figure out if you actually enjoy working as a data scientist, then you'll know even after you graduate, you'll continue learning and you'll continue studying and trying out new things, because ultimately data science is a very fast-paced field. And if you don't keep up with it, I think you'll just be left behind very quickly. And ultimately that will just hinder your career progression and you won't be very happy. So that's it for the video. I hope this has been useful in helping you decide whether or not a data science master's is for you. Please leave a comment down below and let me know what you think. I'd love to hear what your ultimate decision is. And I've actually got a link in the description down below to a blog post where I talk more in depth about what my thought process was at the time and also my experience of the whole data science masters. So if you're interested, check it out. Follow me on Instagram. And if you're interested in seeing more content like this, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace. Do a project like that and you can do it well, I think you're on a very, very good track.